Hi, my name is Lindsay and I work as a developer for Sparkbox. Since I started working on the web in 2015, I have been dedicated to finding accessible website solutions. When I work on a website, I always try to do some quality assurance and accessibility testing on my iPhone 6 using VoiceOver. In this brief tutorial, I'll show you how to use VoiceOver and some of the features that VoiceOver and many other screen readers offer, especially with regard to being able to more effectively browse a web page. At the moment, there is no other substitute I know of that comes close to the findings and solutions that can be discovered by accessibility testing by hand. That is, having a real person testing a live site with a screen reader or via keyboard only on your desktop, mobile, whatever. There are definitely tools out there that can help you evaluate the accessibility of your website, but these tools only scratch the surface of the issues present. And using those tools alone will not mean that you have created an accessible web browsing experience for people with disabilities. To get started, I just want to go through some of the gestures I will be using here, since unfortunately you can't see my hands in this video. Using this Assistive Touch feature over here, see that? I can show you how and where my hands and fingers are moving. In order to navigate around my phone, I will mostly be swiping left and right. So let's see that. So the swipe left. Okay, do that one more time. And swipe right. So those I'm going to be using a lot today. I will also be swiping up and down from time to time to control certain types of functionality in VoiceOver. So that swipe up and down looks a little bit like this. Okay. Lastly, to use the rotor functionality that I will explain to you a bit later, you must use two fingers to create a twisting motion on your screen. This is definitely the hardest gesture to get down. So, the rotor, okay. So I would generally position my pointer finger on the top and my thumb on the bottom and use a clockwise twisting motion to get this rotor to enable. So we'll see. All right, let me do that again because it went off screen. So that's definitely the hardest one to get down, but we'll talk about that more later. Now that we have that gesture knowledge, we will turn on VoiceOver and begin. To turn on VoiceOver, we'll go to our settings, general, accessibility, and VoiceOver. To turn on VoiceOver, we're going to toggle this little button here.
VoiceOver on, settings, accessibility,
back button. Now VoiceOver's on. So I'm going to mute this intermittently so I don't have to talk over the VoiceOver. But I'm going to turn it back on so we can play with the speaking rate on that range. Okay, so I'm going to slide my fingers left to right to go down.
Voice up, tap, double tap, swipe, voice up, speaking rate.
And to increase the speaking rate, I'm going to swipe up. To decrease it, I would swipe down. I'm probably going to leave it at this 50% because it gets pretty hard to hear if it's any higher. And one last thing, if I want to go back to settings, so I'm swiping right to left here. If I wanted to go back and actually click that button, that accessibility button there, I would need to double click. Okay, so that's like a confirmation motion. I have to double click to go anywhere I want to. All right. So since I'm a sighted user, I can also click around randomly rather than just swiping down through everything. I can just click whatever I see. But keep in mind that most users will probably have to swipe through all of the headings or all of the apps to get to their desired endpoint. So let's go to Safari now and open up this website. This is a Medium article about one of my favorite conferences I have ever been to, ELLA Conference in Philadelphia, Conference for Women, Trans Men, and Genderqueer People in Tech. So I wanted to use this as an example for VoiceOver testing. I'm going to turn this back on. I can continue to swipe left and right to go through the website, so let's see a little bit of that.
Address. A Medium Corporation. Reload. Homepage. Go to the profile of Ella Organizers. Ella Organizers. A conference and community all about January 10th, middle 11 minutes read. A candid look at Ella Conf's numbers.
So I'm just swiping left to right to go down this page and go through every single element on the page. So I'll do a little bit of more of that in case you've never seen VoiceOver before. I know this can be kind of jarring to see.
Ella Conf is a conference with a mission of empowering more women to be leaders in tech. One star or Ella Conf 2006. We realized that there.
Okay. So that's how you can get through a website. That's one of the ways you can get through a website. I can also use something called the Rotor that is a piece of functionality VoiceOver enables. The Rotor allows screen reader users to more quickly and more decisively navigate a web page. I can use to navigate via headings alone, which is the way many WebAIM survey respondents said is the primary way they like to find information on a lengthy web page. And that link's on my article. I can also navigate via ARIA landmark roles, links, visited links, containers, form controls, and more. And you can custom set your Rotor options under Settings, General, Accessibility, VoiceOver, Rotor. The Rotor is a really useful feature for people who wish to skip a lot of the content that may be unnecessary for them on a web page, whether it be ads, images, paragraphs, and get straight to the content that they're looking for. So let's actually use that Rotor complicated gesture and see how that works. So again, I'm going to use this twisting motion to activate the Rotor. You'll hear it announced, and you'll hear about different options you can use as I keep twisting.
Links, form control, links, headings, 12 containers.
Okay, and it'll also announce how many of something are generally on a page. I guess there weren't any containers, but if I go back to headings.
Headings, links, headings, 12 headings.
12 headings. Okay, so there's 12 headings on the page. It would also tell me if there were 7 form controls or whatever else I wanted to know about. So if I wanted to navigate by just using the headings, using the Rotor, I would select that Rotor setting and then use a swipe down motion to repeatedly jump between headings. So let me do that for you now.
Links, 27 headings. Links, headings, 12 headings. A candid look at Ella Conf's numbers. Heading level 1. Heading not found. Heading not found. Sharing struggles. Success. And more struggles. Heading level 3. Breakdown by numbers. Attendees and community. Heading level 4. Speakers and sessions. Heading level 4.
Okay, so you see that if I wanted to get quickly to the part of a website I was interested in, using headings could be a really useful way to do that. Just so you don't have to go through every single item on a page, you can browse by the section heading and then read what you're interested in. I also want to point out a couple other good and bad things that this Medium article does for accessibility software. This article does a really good job with their heading structure, making it easy for someone who wants to quickly browse the article with the Rotor heading function to do so, just as we saw. It looks like the authors of this article also put in a helpful alternative image text attribute, or you could call that alt text, for the Ella Conf image at the top. So let's see that. Just going to scroll back up to the top. Went really far down the page. Okay, and let's listen to what that image sounds like.
Cis and trans. Ella, go to the profile of Ella organizers. Link.
Go to the profile of Ella Conf organizers. So this tells a screen reader user that this is a link and exactly where it is taking us if we click on it, without them ever needing to know that this is actually an image, because maybe that doesn't matter. It's more important that it's a link here, and that's what it's telling us, which is great. However, I want to show this other image in the article. This is what people are going to hear. We'll go down a little bit.
Is it one star or YHG3M66M3X9CJ7Q?
So that was just about to say JPEG. That is what it's going to sound like for this image because it doesn't have an alt attribute provided. Instead, the random long ID that is the image's name gets read, which is one stars, like many numbers and letters .jpg. That's what someone's going to hear. So what might have been a lot better is if they had either added some alt text that was descriptive of the image, women laughing at Ella conference or something like that, or just had an empty string of alt text and the screen reader would know then to just skip the image and not read anything. The last thing I want to show you is that for the header of the website, Medium, this is what a screen reader is going to hear.
Ella conf link is a L okay 11 middle jet L go get to homepage link get started homepage link.
Okay, so you see we're focused on that Medium heading and it says homepage link. The reason that it says this, and I had inspected the Medium website beforehand on my computer, is that there's a link surrounding an SVG of the words Medium. So those Medium words are an SVG. And someone just added text in a span tag that is actually meant for screen readers. It just says homepage. So this reads off for a screen reader homepage link. This is okay, but I think it might have been a bit easier and better to add something like an ARIA label to the link that said a bit more descriptively, Medium homepage, rather than just homepage alone. Just being a little more specific in case somebody loses track of where they are in the article. So now you know a lot more about how to use VoiceOver to test your own web pages in ways that users with disabilities may want to navigate the web. Check out the article that goes along with this video for more information about the WebAIM survey that I mentioned and accessibility tools you can use for website testing. Thank you so much.